going to keep going, folks. I just hope you're aware.
Oh, yeah. The corny has just begun.
Yeah, we're pretty much just everything we're spouting out is just filler till we think of an actual topic to discuss, which sometimes the filler is more fun. Let's be honest.
Okay. I'll interject.
Go for it.
HBO is remaking Harry Potter as a TV show, and they're committed to 7 seasons.
I just hope they don't. I hope they stick true to the characters in the book. That's all I ask.
If they start race swapping, I'm not gonna watch it. But if
they already got a race swapped Hermione. But you know what? They might be just in. That's kind of my main kind of theory over this woke stuff. Is if it doesn't fully work, as long as they can get like 25% closer to whatever their agenda is, maybe they're just going to get us to the point where like, fine, we'll race swap everybody. But that's
it. Why did they race swap the ginger again? What the hell?
It's a racist. What else?
What's with this war on redheads? What's with the war on redheads?
Which I don't even have red hair, and I'm sitting there going, man, the gingers are being screwed.
Wait, what redhead got killed this time?
Just like me, they hate Irish people.
Hermione's a ginger.
I'm going to write a story where everybody's a redhead. Well, and watch them scratch their heads as they try and ethno-swap them.
How many of you guys want to bet that somewhere in the middle of between season one and season two, that it'll stop focusing on Harry and start focusing on Hermione?
I don't know if it'll get that far before they do that.
They said that they want to make every season like a book full of. They might just try to do a whole add in wokeness on the side kind of ordeal and keep the main storyline going.
This just seems like a bad idea.
Yeah, well, it's a political correctness with a side of woke.
Hermione's not a redhead, by the way.
She's a brunette. We're at least going to get a gay Dumbledore. Fair enough. Sure.
Man. I think we just need to treat all of these like Bud Light.
Anybody picture a flaming Dumbledore?
Oh, Harry.
Yeah. Yeah, the things that people like to do with hamsters, he did with the phoenix.
Oh, jeez.
I didn't want it. I don't need that crate. Now I got that image in my brain.
I never had a hamster, so I don't know.
As Evelyn Music says, I didn't think the movies were old enough to warrant a TV reboot already, and I feel the same.
Didn't you just make me a thumbnail on this subject?
The first movie came out in, 2001?
The problem is WB's got nothing else right now in terms of what can make money.
Oh, they could try, they could try something new, but fear, they just don't want to, and the market doesn't want it, even though the market's really showing that they want something new.
They're also talking about a reboot of Lord of the Rings, too.
Yeah.
Jonathan just corrected me.
Which I think is a big mistake. You don't want to touch Peter Jackson's stuff.
I think it's the greatest thing to do because you can shit on Rings of Power.
What they are doing right now is they got Peter Jackson on board to do some Lord of the Rings stuff. And from what I hear, they want to do something akin to Rings of Power, as in like it takes place somewhere else at a different timeline. And they're definitely doing an animated series called War of the Rohirrim that takes place a couple
that
of decades.
That one will be good, I think. Hey, James,
if they do it right. Event.
Y'all also have to remember that fucking Warner Brothers has the full rights to the Silmarillion.
Yep. They're the ones. They're Universal. And frankly, I think they're going to be the next Disney, because if they crack that, code and start producing Lord of the Rings stuff, they're the same corporation behind Mario.
As long as they don't touch the Jackson originals, they stand a chance. The moment they touch those Jackson originals, all bets are off.
The sacred text.
Yeah. Well, it's not even that. That's their golden goose. I mean.
Oh, wait. The sacred celluloid.
Maybe what they could do is just take in, there's a lot of other stuff they left out of the movie. Make it about a side character somewhere else.
I agree, Evelyn.
But I think they have a better chance of actually showing it justice, especially after Rings of Power, because that's got to be a beacon to anybody trying to make fantasy stuff.
Well, I'm kind of. This is kind of Warner Brothers, America's dumbest company, by the way.
I am kind of looking forward to the War of the Rohirrim because I've heard that that it's going to be an anime, and it's they're supposedly going to try and make it as close to, you know, the legends as it exists, because I think it's about Helm Hammerhand.
Yeah, and
Helm Hammerhand, he was a boss dude, you know.
Well, hopefully they do him justice, and it'll be good to get some actual, you know, animation made in general that doesn't suck.